lights take a few minutes to get ready. Let's take a few minutes to get ready. Yeah. Oh my god. There's at minimum 6 nodes I can't farm. Da-da-da. Things and stuff and things ready. Interesting. Lovely. Let's get the old chat pad up. Manage my stream. So this defaults to an MMO, does it? Interesting. Cool. Something went wrong with updating your stream info. Oh, how great. That makes me super happy. Oh well. Just send a few people a message. Oh my word. Shh, phone. Shh. Should be quiet now. Where's the fucking... Right. Let's get everything ready. Just do this. Check the volume. We will check our volume in just a moo. Back at again with your stealth. Well, tonight's the last night, mate, of this particular round of Grand Arena. This is the one. Does the volume sound okay, by the way? Yes, lovely. Why is this being so weird nowadays? I also have war to do tonight. Do you mean galactic war? Or what are you talking about with war, my love? What war do you have to do, my love, love? Just, this is weird, but that's... Anyway. Ah, war and strike force. Well... We're doing war on here. Let's Grand Arena it up, baby. Did you like the video, by the way? I told you I'd do it. Shit, I didn't realise these added to my overall score. I didn't know that at all. Otherwise, I would have done that so I could have hit Kyber. I thought you might like the video. Anyway, let's go see. Let's check what the guy has done, if he's done anything today. Let's have a look. Oh, damn! Okay. So he beat them in one. Okay, that's fair. You nerd. I am a nerd. I am. He beat them in one. That's kind of predictable. They are underleveled. Did he try the geos? Probably not. He did. And he lost to Geo's. Okay, so he's got 2 high point wins. Okay. So he's got decently geared Phoenix. The only real threat here is Zeb, because I could do that with Nest, because they don't have a great deal of damage. This is a decent team. I might just go at this full force. I think I'm just going to go at this full force. I think that's what we're going to do here. We're going to fucking full hog this shit. We're going to big dick this. We're not going to underdog it. We're going to big dick him. Because this is a big team on his part, and it's a big team on my part. So I'm a bit worried about Ark here. Oh, fuck me. Let's try and take out Shark T first, because she's a huge part of that team. Bang! Right, she's dead. Where's Fives? Well, no, that's Rex. There's Fives. Hello, Fives. Hello, Fives. We need to kill Fives first, because if we... Exactly. Mega big dick energy. If we kill any other clone except Fives, he sacrifices himself, and they all get mega buffed. They all get, like, insane out the ass buff. So we have to kill Fives first. That's fine. That's what Kenobi's there for. That's what Kenobi do the thing for. We will resurrect him in a minute, though. But I want to get Fives down first. Because if I can kill Fives, then I know I'm okay. Oh, we lost the buffs. Bollocks. Oh, fuck. This is... Oh, that's good. That's good. Okay, and then we will... We're going to go at Rex, because then we're going to resurrect Kenobi. So we get more banners. We want Echo dead. We're not going to get as many banners as I was hoping. But hopefully, there's just, like, fuck all behind this. If there's fuck all behind this, then we're okay. Let's just do a normal attack. Yeah, okay, let's just do a normal attack. We're going to try and recover some... Oh, we haven't got his thing, so we can't get the protection up. Well, let's do this, then everyone gets a little bit of protection. Maybe some people will hit enough to get the thing. 57, that's not too bad. He had a very good team there, so... Well, for my rank, that's a good team. Okay. Okay. What's he got behind it? That looks like a fucking... Okay, he has nothing. Okay, we can fucking... Whew! That is a sigh of relief. That's a sigh of relief right there. That's all level ones. Well, apart from like a level 27. But that is fine. Do this. Oh, you cunt. I didn't think they'd get any turns first. Oh, well. 64 banners. Now we can fuck about. Because now we've won. I'm not a Sith Lord, leave me alone. Can't. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, cool. And Nest. Because I believe Nest can take this. Fine, but the issue is Zeb, because Zeb has daze, and that's the biggest, well, not the biggest, but one of the biggest counters to Nest is a daze. So we want to actually daze all of them, because they have a load of counter attacks as well, to be honest. Yep, thought that might happen. You can have one of them. Doesn't matter if these two die. Does not matter. We are just here for the big dick energy. That's what we want. We want to kill Zeb. Because Zeb is the worrisome one. Let's start spreading some more extortion around, because that lowers speed and that starts increasing and dealing percentage damage. Yes, ching ching. Pew! Let's get a stun on him. Nice. Yeah, unfortunately he's going to heal for those, isn't he? Let's fracture her. Let's keep her a bit locked down. Let's start spreading even more of this. Maybe I'm worrying too much about Daze, and maybe I should be going for Ezra, because he's the only one who actually deals damage on the team. So, maybe we'll lose here. Maybe this is where we will lose, guys. Who knows? Maybe we'll lose. I don't think we will, but maybe we will. Bing, boom. See, the thing is, that's why you bring Nest on her own, just because of the... then they all have to attack her. Oh, wait, we're going to fucking lose this one. I'm pretty sure we're going to lose. I think I underestimated his Ezra. I think that's the issue I have here. Yep, I underestimated his Ezra. I underestimated his Ezra hitting us. It's fine, it's fine, it's what we do. We learn from this. Hera is the big synergy component there. She's gone, so... Like, I'm still, you know, I could still lose this horribly, but I'm less worried because she is the really scary part of that team. Really scary part of that team. Because she lets them all have each other's buffs. Oh yeah, preloaded turn meter. That's a fun thing I forgot about. Combastler, can we get a turn? Yeah, cool. Yep, wonderful. Zappy zappy time. Has anyone got a shock? No? Okay, so we just put why did I put fear on him? That was dumb. He's the only one who didn't need to be feared. We'll get some fucking pain bollocks going on. Can we take him out with this? Probably not. No, nowhere near. Let's get a shock on him, please. No, but we got... What did we get on him? Oh, a corrupted bat meditation. No. Let's just wild lightning him. Well, we didn't get the kill. But that's fine. Yeah, it's fine. All it is that my Nest needs a slightly bigger health pool in general. Because then when she has a bigger health pool, she'll survive stuff like that. It's all about learning, you know? So I'm not super bothered. I'm pretty sure because we took out his strongest team and he didn't think we'd get through that, he didn't even put anything with synergy in the back wall. The back wall was just level 1s and like a random level 27. So we got nearly maximum banners for that. So I'm pretty sure I should have... Well, I guess it's kind of irrelevant. The issue is they all put... there you go. The damage over time killed him. I was going to say they all put debuffs on him and Kanan's thing is he heals when he gets debuffs. Oh dear. Can we get a full clear? Please more crap. Oh, I don't know. It's probably not crap. It's even more... It's even worse. Mate, look. This guy. This guy... Right, this is... This is why I got so pissed off seeing this guy's defense last night. Okay? Because I showed this to my cousin. This bothered me. I'm sure this guy didn't mean this, but this guy did not take me seriously, right? If he's looked at my roster, which he probably has, he's looked at that and thought, oh, he's going to chuck it all on defense or all on offense, right? Looked at my roster and not thought I've got much else going on. Because he doesn't know key players. And then I looked at his roster. The first thing I did is I thought, ooh, even though Han Solo here is a weird pick in this arena team, that's still a strong team because Han with Relic 5 is so much damage, right? And the rest of that team is good. I looked at this team and I thought, ooh, he could throw up like 4 decent defenses and still take a couple of zones. What this guy thought is, nah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to split my top team between defense and attack and I'll wipe him out. And what he did, he wiped out the easier two zones and couldn't get through my big daddy wall. He left his big daddy wall undefended by taking out the Han Solo element. Because then there was very little incentive to go for anyone but Shark T first, which is where he fucked up. I knew how to bait him. He didn't know how to... He seemingly doesn't know how to bait me. So let's just fucking... Who's got an AoE that will hit everything? TIE Fighter Pilot. Now, I ain't saying that, like, this is all necessarily 100%, but I think it's 100%. This guy, I reckon, like, he should have done one or the other. If he had taken his full team on attack and put to one of his others on defense, I might not have got a full clear, and he would have got a full clear, because then he could have punched straight through Geos with that team, but he didn't. And that's why he's going to have taken a big old L. We both fucked up one attack, admittedly, but even if he kills this and then kills this, he does not have... I got a 62 and a 64. He does not have enough to get that instantly. So I'm 99% sure we have just won our final Grand Arena of the month. and placed number one in all of them. I could be entirely wrong. Let's see. Let's have a quick look through and see what we've seen. Right, so we haven't seen Han Solo, so that means he was on attack. So, done, 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 done. Right, I'm going to assume he used the Jedi's on attack. I'm not going to lie to you. So, all of that's done as well. Done, 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 done. We haven't seen the Kylo and the Dengar. We haven't seen them. Done. Again, Jedi on attack. Done. Yeah. There's no... Unless... I will say... Hey, Clompon, how you doing, man? See you later, Al. I will say, unless this guy has kept... yeah, sorry about the commercials. It's just a pre-roll thing. It earns me a little bit of money. So I apologise if they're annoying. I can always turn them off. It really helps with bills and stuff. Unless this guy has... The ellipses is making me really nervous, man. That's proper ominous. Unless this guy's kept, like, his Jedi or some other big hitting team back specifically to hit me right at the end. Unless that's the case... Unless that's the case, we've won. Because he killed these both in one. He fucked up once on the jet... On the... on the Geos. I fucked up once against Phoenix of all things because I was just being silly. I was targeting for... I took Nest, Newt Gunray, and Thrawn into this event. And I could have won, but I was so paranoid about Zeb's dazes ruining the counterattacks from Nest. I didn't bother with Ezra. And I had so many turns to deal with Ezra. I fractured three times. That's how many fucking turns I had. I did three fractures on three separate people because I was super paranoid about Ezra. About Zeb. But didn't go for Ezra. That was entirely my mistake. That was just fucking silly. And then, although my back rows... This is not a great team, but it's quite strong. And although this is... This is a shit team, right? Because they're barely leveled, they have no mods, whatever. They're better than his back rows. Of his back rows, this was the strongest one. That was the stronger one. So. Yeah. That was the stronger one. And there's that. He didn't even put, like, some level fucking... He's got, like, an 85 green window. Could have at least chucked that there. I'd have had to use two people. I threw under-leveled, blue-geared Grand Moff Tarkin at that. And a level 65 TIE Fighter pilot at that. Let's have a quick look. So, if he takes both of these, that's 300. Which will put him at 1,079. Which means he'll be 102 off... So he could conceivably win with two average wins here. Conceivably he could win. But I don't think he's going to get through Geos. I know this doesn't look like they've got a lot left. I know it looks like they're all fairly hurt, but I don't know I assume you used Geos because you were talking about them the other night. But Geos equalise their health and all that bollocky stuff. And they attack so much. And blah, blah, blah. They're just kind of fucking mental. Yeah, look, there you go. Geosims got 3% protection when they use their basic abilities. And 50% health steal. So, but considering my team is like this underleveled in places, like that. Oh, damn. Yeah, two solos, one underdog. Well, that did turn into a second loss, to be fair, so that's my mistake. And one. As I said. The guy shouldn't have split his arena team like he did. I split my arena team, but in either full of defense or full attack, I'll split them. Normally, I'll split them into two squads in attack. He split his between attack and defense because he didn't think my... He looked at my stuff and didn't think I could put up a good defense, is basically it. So I think we've got... I think this is going to be it. We are... What is... I didn't realize how much I cared. I am going to get 1,000 if I win. I'm going to be just 2,000 short of getting Kyber on my first proper run. Which is pretty fucking cool, guys. I know it gets harder as you go, but I'm a little bit chuffed by that, by getting so far. I mean, our first proper chug at it, you know? That's really fucking cool. And today we did a few things. I managed to finish off two events I've been struggling with a while. So now we have 7-star Thrawn and 7-star R2-D2, whereas before they were both stuck at 6 stars. I've decided I'm just going to go for CLS now. I'm going to get Commander Luke Skywalker, and he's going to be even more useful for underdogging. Because I'm probably not going to, at least for a while, build a full Rebellion team. But when I split my top two and I get my Bastila lead, or CLS lead, with a Bastila behind, or vice versa, that's going to be pretty good. It's going to be pretty good, guys. Do some mods for some reason. So how you doing tonight, Ver? How you doing? You good, my man? It's nice to see you again, popping up. Sometimes we don't see people for a while after they pop up. May have mentioned under and overdogging on another stream. Well, I mean, underdogging is widely known, but like, I could be the first overdogger. Oh dear. Yeah, I'm definitely underdogging is definitely a widely known thing, but I may be the world patented overdogger. Or a complete fucking idiot. Who knows? Oh, mate. I wish I had enough money to just smash a load into this game. Because honestly, if I was like proper minted, I would love... Right now, I'd be like, right, okay, guys, you know what? We're unlocking CLS tonight. And I'd fucking smash the just everything to get these three up. And I'm like, bam, let's go. You know what I mean? But obviously I don't. Otherwise I would. And I'd be a lot more popular than I am. Spending that money. Actually, I'm going to wait. Because I'm going to wait till after midnight so I can get my dailies in. Oh, hello. Yes, please. It's always good to check after every 6-hour reset to see if there's any weird places where you can get shards for people you're farming that aren't, you know, just money packs. Because they don't all, sometimes they pop up outside of where they normally would. So it's always... always a thing to check. Oop. I bought those two from the arena store earlier. This is just not going to get... I'm not going to waste materials on that. I'm working on a dissertation. So I can't really go high on the game or anything else for that matter. Oh, what are you doing your dissertation on, if you don't mind me asking? Or a dissertation, to be fair. Saying your dissertation implies university, which I don't know if it's solely a university thing or what. You know, don't want to make assumptions about other people's lives, to be fair. My dissertation from university was a pile of wank. To be fair, I spent most of my time at university doing practical studies rather than university dissertation. So. Jesus Christ, my man. Higher education, curriculum development with a focus on esports. That is some deep shit right there. What do you think about what Ninja said? You see what Ninja said today or yesterday? Fucking 10 battles won. What RNG is that? What's your hot take with your esport focused mind, my man? I personally fucking hate Ninja. I really do. He's such a turd. The annoying thing is what he said. Like the message of what he's trying to say. Not sure what he said. Don't like him. Yeah, I don't like him at all. This is the thing, though, right? And I'll tell you what he said. And I'll tell you why it bothered me. Especially because I knew he would do it. Especially his fucking response. I see. I get ya. Alright, so look, let's find this motherfucker right here. Let's find what he said. And I will explain why this bothers me and what he said, etc. So, where the fuck is it? The phrase, "it's just a game," is such a weak mindset. You are okay of what happened, losing, imperfection of a craft. When you stop Getting angry after losing, you've lost twice. There's always something to learn and always something to room for improvement. Never settle. Now, the thing about this, right, is the actual intention of that message, when you decompact it and you analyze it and break it down, the message of that actually isn't that bad, right? Like, the message there, once you've decompartmentalized it and actually analyzed what he's saying, is like, you know, learn from your failures and become better and move forward. I actually agree with that. However, and this is why I know he doesn't actually mean that, because I knew exactly what he was going to fucking do with his responses to people. Yes, he is really good at giving crap advice. It's because the way he's worded that, and keep in mind that he's like one of the biggest or the biggest Fortnite player in the world. So his audience is primarily younger teens. That justifies, the way he has worded that justifies toxic behavior. It justifies all of that, because it doesn't say, like, you know, learn from your mistakes. It's like, you're right, fuck boy, you're right being a loser. Well, you're a loser. You're not good as me, the cunt with blue hair sitting in a fucking room flossing. That's the issue I have. He's worded it that way on purpose to get a reactionary response from his young fans. And then, and this is, as I said, this is where I knew he would fucking do this, and this is why I think it's kind of malicious, is because people have started pointing out, like, hey man, like, this is just going to justify toxic behavior. I'm sure you meant, like, and then he will take one line of either what he said or what they said, thusly removing context and the greater, you know, extrapolation, and be like, it's reducto ad absurdum, because he'll be like, that's not what I said, where in my message, like, because someone said, the way you've worded this is going to justify these kids, like, yelling at loved ones, smashing keyboards and thinking like it's okay because you've told them blah blah blah. And he's like, he literally quotes one part, and he's like, the bit where it's like, don't let, like, always there's room for improvement. It's like, where did I justify saying smashing keyboards? And I'm like, you're doing it on purpose. It's reducto ad absurdum. You're taking part of the argument and taking it to a ridiculous extreme to try and make their argument seem invalid. But it's not. You might not have meant it's fine to smash a keyboard and do all this shit, but that's how it's come across. You need to fucking address this, you giant cunty man-child. Right? You aren't wrong here. Sorry, I know I'm on a bit of a tangent. I apologise, guys. It just really bothered me. It really fucking bothered me. A lot. How he worded it. And that when he's trying to treat people like they're fucking idiots behind the scenes and stuff like that, it's just... it really irks me, you know? And the thing is, it's like, as soon as like some big person with traction will call him out for it, he'll be like, hey, no, man, what I totally meant was what, you know, like, oh, it's all positive and that. You're just fucking taking what you want because you want to smear me. And it's like, just maybe stop being such a massive cunt your entire life. Maybe consider that, Ninja. Maybe the fact that you got all this stuff because you're very good, very talented, cannot deny that, very talented, at one fucking game that came up and you got, like, super lucky with getting on the band train, and you did good. He has built his brand, and he is undoubtedly a talented player at that game. But it doesn't mean he's not a shitty person. That's all I'll say. And I apologise for the rant. I needed to say it, obviously. I'm sorry. Hopefully we win the Grand Arena. I like talking about logical fallacies. It's great. Well, I do too. I do. I'm not going to say I don't get tripped up by them myself, and I don't indulge in them from time to time. But we're not going to do barely any damage with this, but, like, I'm just going to chat while we do, like, you know. But yeah, it's just like, it upsets me sometimes because, like, I know realistically, bar some fucking magical occurrence coming up and happening, I'm always going to be a very small Twitch streamer, YouTuber, whatever. I'm never going to be a big media personality, right? But I sometimes sit here and I'm like, I really wish I could fucking just talk to these people and be like, look, you need to sort of take a step back and extrapolate some of this shit, you know? Like, you need to think about what you're doing. Because shit's not cute. It's not cute, man. And I fully believe he knows what he's doing. He knows exactly what he's doing. What buff even is this? Advantage, okay. Like, he's not... As much as he's a fucking demented cunt, he knows what he's doing. He knows the audience, and he knows... Like, part of me thinks it's because we're in this, like, waning period. We're in this period where, like, Fortnite's definitely on a downturn at the moment. Not necessarily permanently, but just in general. He's like, oh, shit, better stir up some controversy. Better get, like, Keemstar all fucking riled up. Because he knows that his, he needs to maintain his shit, especially... Absolutely, like when he moves very twitchy, he knows how to get attention. He does. He fully knows. He knows how to support his brand. I'll grant him that. He fully knows how to support his brand. But that's the thing. He's like, oh, don't get me wrong. Twitch has a lot of issues. A lot of issues. But he moved away and he thought it was going to be this meteoric, cataclysmic, amazing event. And, like, it just wasn't. So he's like, shit, how do I stay relevant nowadays? Oh, I know, I'll do a Keemstar. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a Keemstar in this motherfucker. And I'm going to just fucking overreact to everything and make all this fucking unnecessary controversy at all times. Because that's the way to act. I've decided. Huzzah. We want to target the weakest link just to pop Saviour. So I guess we will just go for Bindo in case we get some lucky hits. Nope, none of those lucky hits to be found. Oh, let's spread some buffs. Let's try and ignore some of their hits with our own foresight. Okay, dope. Why didn't... Yes, kill Bastila for us. That is super okay. Yep, you go for it, baby girl. And that's the thing, like, as I say, 100% he's done it on purpose, and he's worded it. Ugh, I'm gonna get so frustrated with this fight. He, no matter what he says, he's done this on purpose, and I think that's really shitty of him. And, like, he'll be like, and if he gets called out, if he ever gets called out, I guarantee you he'll play dumb and be like, I didn't know that not acknowledging what people said and just taking part of the argument was some kind of awful logical fallacy. I thought that's just what you did. Herp a derp a derp. And he'll act like that's the normal thing that normal people do. It's like, no, it's really not, you fucking absolute tool. It's really not. We haven't even popped Saviour yet. Oh my god, this fucking fight. Yeah, it just bothers me because that feels very malicious to me, and I don't know, I just hear a lot of these stories of people dealing with a lot of, like, high level Twitch stream, fucking god, Twitch streamers who just don't really appreciate what they've got. Like, there's one of the regulars in my stream. He's a lovely, lovely guy. He works his fucking ass off all the time, right? But he tells me sometimes, self-care. He's a lovely, lovely guy. Works his fucking ass off. He comes into the stream, and there was a streamer he used to watch who told him that if he didn't sub to him and give him money, then he should get out of his stream because he's not worth it. And that fucking was just so sickening to me. And I'm just like, come on, man. These people, like, you can't... Without subs and donations... Oh, I just turned that up massively on my own headset. Holy shit, that hurt my ears. And without people's subs and donations, then you're kind of nothing, right? You know what I mean? You kind of... You don't get anywhere. You're just... So, like... You've got to respect people, surely. I mean, obviously not, and I'm just a fucking idiot. What would I know, I guess? I'm some fucking dickhead sat on a Thursday night... Thursday night? Thursday night. Playing a fucking mobile game with 83 followers. What do I know about talking about Ninja and other multi-millionaire streamers? Not a lot. But I tell you what I do know, I do know about not being a complete shite bag of a person. I may not be the best person, but I'm not that awful. And some of these people really are that awful. What are you going to do, huh? I mean, lose this fight still somehow to some miraculous RNG, I'm sure. But... I don't want to... Like, this is one thing I hate in this mirror match, is when you pop Retribution with Kenobi, their Yoda always copies it. And so it's like, well, I'm the one with Retribution. They're like, no, me. Stop gaining foresight. I'm the one with foresight here. I like that. He dodged three attacks. We've got fucking 43 seconds. We've got a full auto. I like this line of thought. Oh man, I'm clearly just wrong. I don't know. There's just... I just think there's some top streamers who are so fucking awesome, right? They're just wonderful. We're going to time out. They're just so nice and they work so hard. And even like Ninja works really hard. I'm not going to say that. But like... Yeah, I feel like it gets to a point where they're... Some streamers try and balance the work they put in with the person they are, right? And they struggle with that and it goes up and up and up. And they just... They keep it level. Because it's... Fueling both of those is a real fucking struggle, you dig? And like... I mean, I don't want to name any specific streamers who are, I think that... Because I could be entirely wrong about them. So... But then there are other streamers who just let their personality just drop to this fucking toxic cesspool. While they get... They just... Like, they're wrong. They put the mechanical work in. They are fucking stupid hard working. And I want to fucking fight that on the far right. Because that looks like I could beat Obmixilus, the Magic the Gathering reference. And it just seems like they let their personality slip into this shit, scummy, cunt personality. While they... They put in a lot of work and get a lot of mechanical sets, become very good at the games, doing stuff like that, but they let themselves just fall off as a person. You know? And, I don't know, I never want to turn around one day and realise that, yeah, I've become very successful, but, like, it's the classic Scrooge sort of situation, isn't it? I never want to turn around and realise I'm really successful, but it was at the expense of absolutely everyone that I gave a shit about. And who cared about me. I don't want that to ever be the case. Which is why I take long breaks from the streets sometimes, because it's very tiring. Very tiring. Like, they have my full-on respect for the amount they put in. I'm not ever trying to take that away from them. But... no, man. Sometimes you gotta think the amount you put in takes away from yourself. Some of these kids need to fucking realise that that day has come a lot sooner than they thought it ever would. Also, I can't do a super long stream tonight just because I fell down the stairs yesterday. And not like fully head over, like arse over tit, but enough to really fucking hurt my back. And I couldn't leave tonight. Couldn't leave tonight because, guys, man, the last Grand Arena for this month. I had to share it with you guys. I had to. No way I could just leave that. I'm going to go for Hermit Yoda next. If you can, Veer, if you can save these for a Hermit Yoda, you should. Because Hermit Yoda's amazing. In, like, everything. I think we can take this. Because we took something similar just now. He doesn't have the Zeta on Bastila or on Obi-Wan. He's got the 3 on Fuckboy, which is an issue. Let's have a look at what some other bits is going on. Oh, I'm 189. Sick. Oh yeah, and that's a Gear 12 Bastila as well, which means that there's a big difference. Gear 11 Bastila. There's a big old difference in stats going on there. Pew. Battle Meditation. Yeah. He has got a lot in them, huh? He's gone for offense set? Interesting. Oh my god, offense primary as well. That is... I mean, yeah, but have you got any crit chance? Are you ever going to crit to use that? I mean, you crit just under half the time, I guess. Damage is 5,100. What's my damage like, huh? I can't check. Let's have a look at my Yoda's stats. Maybe I'm not one to criticise. It's been a long time since I've redone Yoda's mods, so... There is a Zeta on this, though. I thought there was. Yeah, I might need to redo some of these mods at some point. I've got less crit chance and less that. Oh my god, I've got half the damage. I need to redo these fucking... Holy shit, yeah, I need to really rework some of these mods. Bollocks. Okay, yeah, I take everything back. He's right and I'm wrong. He's good at the game and I'm awful. Yeah, fucking Christ. Really? Me? Really? What is... I guess it's crit chance. And tenacity is not... What am I doing with my life? Yeah, no, the guy's just better than me. I'm a fucking moron. Ignore me. Go watch his stream. Go watch Ob Nixilis' stream. Does he have a stream? I don't fucking know. Unless we win, in which case, stay with me. I want to target... Oh, bollocks. Interesting. Interesting. We're going to try and pop Saber off of his Revan first, because it's going to be weaker than his... window in terms of health. Yeah, I knew that was going to pop so good. Holy balls. Okay, his Yoda, infinitely superior to mine. I was fully wrong, and I should have kept my fucking mouth shut. How's that, guys? Because that's looking very true right now. Oh my god, my Bindo's fucked. Sucker! I mean, I'm still fucked. Oh, we are gonna lose this fight. Yeah, we've already lost. We've already lost. We're gonna play it out. We're gonna play it out. Yep, dead. He's won because his Yoda is better. I fully underestimated his Yoda. I thought mine was better, but I haven't looked at my stats in ages. So, no. I was just... 100% incorrect. I really need to redo Yoda, then fucking hell. What's a Revan? I mean, Revan, I can't even realistically look at Revan because he's fucking Relic 3, isn't he? So of course he's going to have better stats now than my Yoda. Yeah. Such a huge stat jump. I need to get Yoda Relic'd, but I've only just got Revan Relic'd. And it takes a fucking lot, man. It takes so much shit. Like, these fucking things annoy me up to no end because I've beaten this on 2 stars. Oh. We'll get Yoda there. In a couple of years, maybe. We're nearly on this thing. Yeah. We need 3 of this. We could get 25. Holy shit. Oh, we can buy that in, hopefully, an hour and 20 minutes. If we win, we can buy that, and we'll at least get another piece of gear, gear 13 for Yoda. That's a decent one right there. This one is going to take me a day and an age because of these. I had so many of these, but I smashed them into Shakti. Absolutely smashed them into Shakti because I wanted to get her like a decent level up. How much was that? That's 15 quid large and hard. Like 5? I fucking called it. They don't like you to get ahead in this game. Unless you spend the big monies. This one will take a fucking age. It's got one of those as well. And one of these. Holy shit. Holy shit, guys. And these, which are just really irritating to get as well. It doesn't matter anyway. Fuck it. Fuck it. Fuck it all. Well, I think think I need to bug in work or something. Like, why is this not a speed one? Why have I not got a speed primary here? Maybe I don't have any left. I have some somewhere. I might need to... We'll come back, guys, once we've... another time. But, guys, thank you so, so fucking much for joining us tonight. It has been an absolute honour and a pleasure and a fucking privilege to have you all here. Thank you, everyone in the chat. It has been wonderful. Love you guys very, very much. I'll catch you guys soon. I will post the results on my Twitch and my Instagram, which is at DarkPaladin111 on both. And hopefully when my back recovers, I'll see you guys very soon in the next few nights. Thank you guys very much. Peace and love. You be the best people you can be. Ninja's a cunt. I'll see you later.